thank you for coming. In my thesis, I want to focus on one key definition. We say a set of integers is primitive if no member in the set divides any of the others. For example, the set of primes is a primitive set because no prime divides another. And more generally, for any integer k, the set of numbers with exactly k prime factors forms a primitive set. So this definition is very simple, and hence admits a very broad class of sets. Historically, people have been interested in so-called perfect numbers. So since ancient Greece, we say a number is perfect if it equals the sum of its proper divisors. For example, 6 has proper divisors 1, 2, and 3, which add together to give 6 again. So we number theorists often think of the primes as these very special, beautiful objects, like a diamond. And I'd encourage you to think of, more generally, the broader class of primitive sets as a treasure trove of these precious jewels, including emeralds, rubies, sapphires, and so on. And just like precious gems, each have special properties. For example, their brilliance, their color, value, rarity. We want to think of each of these primitive sets having special properties. For example, the primes, by the prime number theorem, we know that the primes become more and more rare the further out we go along the number line. And technically speaking, we'd say that the primes have density zero. In 1935, the great mathematician Paul Erdős generalized this result considerably. He proved that any primitive set has lower density zero. And in the course of his proof, he came up with a formula, f of a for every primitive set a, which detects the size of these rare sets, even if they have density zero. And in 1988, he famously conjectured that his formula, f of a, is bounded by f of the primes for any primitive set a. So in other words, the Erdős primitive set conjecture asserts that the primes are maximal among all primitive sets. And when I first heard about this conjecture, I absolutely fell in love with the problem because it really gives us some concrete sense in which the primes are special in a broader context. And in general in life, it's not often easy to kind of describe articulately why we love the things we do. So I've been working on this problem for many years and tried several approaches. But recently, in the winter, during lockdown, I found that there was a beautiful connection with this problem to probability theory and actually enabled the solution to this problem. So I can now say with great pleasure that the Erdős primitive set conjecture is true. Thank you.